So, we have the team we need for Mono. We need to finish our prep. We're pretty efficient. No potion should we need? Alright, let's go. This Master Archer's a little scary, but let's do it. It's good money. This up and then get back to work. So we need to find Idrok, finish leveling, buy potions. We also need to find monastery. We need to find monolith. And I think if I'm fast, fingers crossed, chat, we can be at monolith next turn. We really don't have that much more to do. We have growth, right? That nimble bro, I'm probably gonna pull him back a little bit. Like, he's fine, he's not injured or anything, but. And I, like, don't respect his dog at all, right? Like, I don't care. I don't care about the XP, anything. You're done. the Master Archer, like, whatever. He's worth a lot of XP, but in the world, like, if he gets away, I'm not gonna cry. I'm just happy to, I'm happy to make money this fight and call it good. Ah. On the other hand, what's crazy is like these bros aren't gods. We have one hedge knight who rolled okay, and then I have lowborn that are outright better than that hedge knight. Plenty actually, but that was kind of a fun roll. Gotta keep it interesting. We're done throwing things at him this fight, probably. For the attachment. Yeah, we have a guy in a 210, we have a guy in 230 with an attachment. This is fine. Like, it's money. Alright. Noble War should end soon. Kinda unbothered by the Noble War. Thank you. Mark that as a favorite. Alright, let's go. I like 5 plus holy water in Monolith. I'll do it with 4. I really don't want to do Monolith with 3. But 5 is like a fine number. Well, let's see if we can get something useful here. We'll sell. We're looking for armor. We need noble swords for backliners, for necro savant control and monolith. But we have stuff we need to do. That is a very good sword. Shame we're not on it. $300 mil. I have Battleforge bros that are really squishy, and we're trying to get this rock done. There will be more things. The pauldrons are really ugly, but I'm gonna buy them. Sell like 16 and also like walking back. I actually need regular jazz right now? I kind of do. I have like no barbarians on my map. This is fine. Trying to finish baking some of these high value dudes. We're done rolling on bros. That's a 300 helm. I want it in the Noble War so I can shop up north as well. That's also a thing. I don't want to do this quest. I don't want to do that quest because our team is set, and like that quest is just a great way to lose bros. Like there's so many enemies on screen. Friendly AI has rotate. Like, just if I wasn't working towards Monolith, I would just do it, right? What is this? They're probably gonna be rock unhold. It's one skull. I'll fight unhold. If it's miserable, I'll cancel. They're probably going to be southern unholds. I mean, I know they'll be southern, right? So they'll be rock unholds. It's just, is it an obscene number? Five, and they're bog unholds. They're green. They're low tier. It's fine. I fight this all day. Shift everybody down. Another Indom bro I could have brought into this. If I didn't. I wonder if I'll regret that. this is fine. I'll intern here. Like if that attack up there didn't miss, you're dead. I played the fight badly, but it like low-key doesn't matter because these are bog on hold. These are northern on hold. I'd be in a lot of pain. Like I'd be getting punished. Wait for this one to act, and then I'll attack him with this guy. I'll burn this one down. Your shield doing fine. Okay. Enough for a bone plating. Time to get paid. And then we'll push north. Who needs it? Force that guy to be a hammer bro. Like, we're just gonna make it work. Let's see. So we're forcing him to be a hammer bro and hold the flank. He's gonna need hammer spec, but I'm not gonna equip the hammer yet, right? Like, we're gonna get all of his stam levels done. Can I not commit to making him a hammer? Against that, not working. I don't want him to build a hammer. I guess he already has brawny. So we can start with Zerk Frenzy. He's like super awkward, right? Because he already has quick hands too. It's awkward. So he's actually probably Axe-Spec. Because we already took quick hands, which is not a perk we normally take for that build. Like, he's missing perk slots. Unless we're just okay with quick hands and no steel bra, that's probably fine. Griffin would be, but it's probably fine. Either way, we can do Killing Frenzy and not commit. Probably like gonna be more than strong enough for Monolith. I'm just like, this will be my first time doing Monolith on stream. I've done it a bunch of times at this difficulty, but like, I'm kind of paranoid. Like, I don't want to get blown out on stream. Like, oh, you made it to Monolith, but you got wiped. So you're terrible at this game. It's like, I'm nowhere near the best, but. Nobody wants to be blown out on camera, right? Like, public humiliation, right? We don't make money there. We need a little bit of food. We, like, never catch this caravan, right? There's a scripted ambush here. There's a scripted ambush here. And I think there's one over here. So we just never make it to that caravan. Let's just go ahead and get north. This is undead camp. Let's hit that undead camp. Like, we need money to buy gear. This is fine. And obviously we're just gonna back up so we're not like on a cliff. There's a necro. There's a universe for like not trying to back up so far, right? Like, there's an argument for it, but no necro, so I don't really care. We didn't reload our nets. This should be an easy fight. Also, probably should have taken an XP pot for this. I see valuable weapons to sell. Alright. Is anybody damaged, by the way? After that on-hold fight, his armor's a little scuffed, but it's fine. Just wait for them to come to us. Joining us here in chat, welcome. Feel free to ask any questions you got. Feel free to give commentary on your theories or things you like. I'm all about it. Already, or did they not? Like, I wish I could extend this bar out. I think I was just passing. Yeah, they haven't moved yet. I know they did move. I could have thrown there. Got sidetracked. I don't know if I want to throw at that distance anyway. Like, these things have 100 HP. Like, 100 million HP. 130 to be exact, which might as well be 100 million. I feel like I thought there were more DB Warfall heroes in this game. That's what it was. There were a bunch of nachos in this camp. Let's see if we I'm not really thinking about this fight. I'm thinking about our route after this fight. to watch my flanks. Tier 2s are fine. That's bad if you don't have to do it. Make sure our food doesn't get away. That one's not getting up. Okay. getting paid. Also, from playing. That's also a thing. These two are backwards. He's on the edge. He gets bone plating. Forced one. That's awful. I'm getting ready to get forced to take ones like for the remainder of these guys' roll. Feels bad. I mean, he can just carry the pole hammer for now. Like, he's not neutral swinging it, but yeah, he doesn't have to carry the pole hammer. Go buy ammo. That's unfortunate. Okay, quickest place to get ammo is like all the way down there. Unless I go this way and then go across. So I'm 285 mil. I will dagger that. Don't have any of my nets. How do I want to do this? They're like bottled up pretty good in here. If I back up, they'll come out of that. Because the archers will come forward. Oh, even better. I don't have to back up anymore. I can just go forward now. Why are they running at me? They have more range than me, don't they? I guess not. Let's go. Change of plans. Everything's engaged, they should run forward. There we go. We like 100% right? I just don't have any nets. It's like super unfortunate. I wasn't expecting hedges. I mean, I guess it's day 150, right? So they can spawn. So I should definitely at least have the nets like ready. Crossbow's gonna chew us up though. He has a bar D-shot, he's just standing there. Crossbows are why we put AFPs on additional buff adding on guys. Get Pearson. He wants to be on my range, bro, y'all. That's unfortunate. You're fine where you're at. Arrows are kind of messing you up a little bit. You wait. Controlling his head without scuffling his ears and getting another matches. Probably would have been better to try and line up the tank into him. Good spot. This guy's damaged, this guy's not damaged. This is gonna hurt. Yep. Still gonna dagger him. I'm gonna build a new tempo hybrid in like 2 minutes if I need to. Here in case he tries to run. He'll be able to get there next time. Check that. two of my dagger guys go. He doesn't kill any of these two guys. Actually, he probably misses. Nope. Did not miss. Ooh. Coming from a card game background, if your life total is a resource, right? Oh! Also, after this fight, put Nance back in the guys. Like, that's a thing. Like instantly better armor.
Everybody,
this should be a long axe. He has quick hands now. Dual hook is fine for him. Let's just go down here and buy ammo. That fight I don't want, we're a little scuffed up. Alright. So we need to buy ammo and like not get distracted. He said as a camp appeared. Is it on? It's on. It's just on a hill. Ugh. 50. That's 100. See what it looks like after we refill. Okay. I'm gonna splurge on another one to make sure we're maxed. Oh, there was a cheaper one right here. Can't get distracted. Ammo is a real constraint for us. So I need to save that ammo if I'm gonna do what I need to do up north. And I need to go kill Idjarok. Like that's what we're trying to do. I just keep getting distracted by juicy fights. Wasn't there. Okay. Alright. Back to work. Now, as I was saying, we're gonna go north. We're gonna go north. Food is cheap here? Oh, yeah. To try and find Idjarok. No distractions this time, guys. We like fought the unhold. We saw a camp. We were like, we're gonna fight this camp. We were like, grab an ammo. We dagger the edge. I keep forgetting them because I have them like on my guy. Brigands. We will prioritize, like if we see a hedge or a champion, we will go into the brigands. Because like champions for fans. We can do this fight without using any ammo. Just to be quick. I guess what I'm actually supposed to do is use that first turn to put nets on the ground and pull out pole arms and other guys. But it just doesn't matter in this fight. Like we're gonna melt this really quick. Thank you.
So far, so good.
Just nice, clean fights like this. We need money for potions. I should probably write down my monolith like checklist at some point instead of just trying to remember it all. I mean, for the amount of work we did, it's fine profit. There's like no work. Alright. So let's go find Idrog. If we find a noble stack, we want to fight. What is this? Nachos, don't care. If we find a noble stack, we want to fight. En route, we'll fight it. We're like, kind of care about this because we need to be able to shop up north. That's about the only reason we care. This alleyway has been really good to us because that's the way the mercenaries are using to go to fight the other faction. So we've just been like catching mercenaries right there. It's actually been really nice. All right. So Idrarok will preferentially spawn in a part of the map a part of the tundra you haven't cleared. It's probably over here somewhere. So we're gonna go look over there. Watch it. I'm gonna go look over there and it's being this like one of these, like this tiny little sliver over here or something like that. We have cleared most of the tundra, so it's possible that it spawns somewhere else. Or like we've seen most of the tundra, I should say. This is also goblin country. There's probably not that much room for it to spawn, right? Good on food. Goblins chasing undead. Those are goblins doing their thing. Not interested in them at all. We also need to find Mama. So poking our head out around here isn't necessarily the worst thing in the world. I'll check this little corner up here, then I'll go down here. I'll fight this orc camp. We need to be careful not to like burn resources. This is goblins. I should also probably be zoomed in. I know it's goblin country. Popping the orc camp for strange meat, because like food is a thing, or like out here looking for this. Just take a look. Yeah. This is cozy. I don't like all this stuff blocking my throwing lanes. I'm just gonna back up. For a turn. Didn't put Nance back on my guy. I wish there was like a default loadout button. That would be super sweet. I'm sure there has to be. Also, tank can like get a lot of value this way. Like, you can run up and tank these warriors with thought for me. Sparking up everything else. Unless the warriors just come in. I've moved these guys around. Like, I learned that kind of move guys around since then. If he runs here, it'll force the warrior to come inside, which is fine. So, for people who say fearsome doesn't work, it never matters. Like, we have one more hit and he's done. Like, one more failed morale check and he's done. Like, off of two jabs that dealt 19 damage. To swap shields. Oh, that was my fame shield. Oh, that's what I get for being cocky. Oh, this is a visual bug from the mod. It doesn't actually have this stuff. I thought it was forward. I was like, why are you not swapping? We don't need to use ammo this fight. Or any more ammo. Pocket shield, go. He'll stop swinging on him now, so I guess it's fine. plenty of tools. You have like a whole bunch of ground to cover looking for this thing. Just goes extra medium. Also, wouldn't mind fighting Scrats. Looking for a light armor attachment. How many unhooks is that? That's 9 unhooks. Get off me, bro. That's Ancient Temple. We can do that on the way back. Because we need the holy water. Are they running or are they coming? Oh, that's so many goblins. Leave me alone. I just want to do Interrock while I'm out here. I'm gonna have to like fight a goblin camp for like strange meat or something. Whatever food item they drop. Or like maybe I'll find a rock or something. But it's unlikely. Also, like, we got strange meat at that camp, right? There he is. You don't do anything this fight. I would rather have a guy who's at least capable of doing damage. The nimble guys are fine. These guys are a little squishy. This guy's fine. He probably wants a big boy weapon for this fight. He doesn't have quick hands yet, so he's gonna have a hard time getting attacks. Does everybody have what I want them to have for this fight? And then at the start of the fight, it ports into your back line, right? To a page maybe to spread out a little bit, I guess. I don't have a good strategy for this guy at all. And he usually hits you center on his first attack turn. Alright, let's do it. We might wipe here. Let's do it. See what I mean? going to spread out a little bit. I don't know what direction he's going to hit us from. And I don't want this guy on the outside anywhere. This guy out of spell range. Think about this thing like fighting Alps, just like you just never get, like you have to manage spacing. Big boy hit right there, huh? Healing 100 turns. That's bad. He's going right on 1-2. Close. So close. Watch. He's got one hit left. This is the turn he kills somebody. Wow. Okay. I'm in shock. I guess it still has a turn. Nope. Up there. But actually we didn't get as torn even get as torn up as I thought we were. Just very good. This can go here. It's like more fatigue efficient than what we were doing, right? Now that frees up Battleforged armor for him. You come out. Oh man, it's like just feels so much better now. Like feels so much better. So Idrock clear. Let's hit monastery and then like work our way back before we run out of food. Hex and that's a lot of weapons. That is an obscene amount of spiders. I'm trying to like hold this angle to get by him. Okay. So we'll do this, get our holy water, and then we need to get back before we run out of food. Still need a little bit more holy water for my life, but like that looks great. Where's the quickest place to get food? Probably dip back down there, buy food and ammo, and then come back up north. So we need to find Monolith. That's a task on the list. We actually need to find it. I don't mind dipping my toe into orc country here, because like clearing a small orc camp, getting some strange meat would like take some of the pressure off of us right now. I see this orc camp, but I think that one's probably too spicy. Idrock clear, that early is huge. a little banged up, but this camp should be fine still. Like, we just need the strange meat to make sure we make it back to town, right? 32 food we probably make it without killing this camp, but also, it's a camp. Let's fight it. We don't have a full bag. This is fine. This guy could even tank for us this fight if we wanted. He'd like actually tank for us this fight. Let's actually use our tank. How about that? As long as the tank goes forward, we know Lone Wolf is triggered. He does not have a spare shield in his pocket. That's a thing to think about. But yeah. Oh man. I'm so glad we didn't take any losses in Hidjarok there. Like, sometimes I fight this thing. Great dice roll. The tank is staying forward out of the formation, so this is our spacing now. Oh, he does have a spear. Okay. This guy could frontline. So I leave him right where he's at. They're gonna avoid him. Am I happy if he ties up a warrior? Like, I'm happy if he ties up a warrior and makes their movement awkward here. Can't be pulled. What am I doing? I'm tripping. So three is the number. I back up three and they run right to me. Come back before I finish this fight anyway. I want a net so that I can get pushed, huh? Don't need to use more ammo in this fight. The only person when I was like a brand new player, I tried to dagger down an orc for his armor, an orc warrior for their armor. Tell me I'm not the only person who did that, like, when they were brand new. Like, obviously, we know better now. That was a long time ago. But that's like a rite of passage in this game. Because you're like, well, it's really heavy armor, and everything else, if I dagger down, I get it, right? Thank you. strange meat? Plenty. It's like about to expire time now, but at least it gets us back to town. Question mark? So this guy should just like be on a flank already, right? I guess he doesn't have brawny yet, huh? But he should definitely not have a pike. But once he gets brawny, he's in there. That went well. Alright. Why did I not see any food in my inventory? This is one unit of food. Am I sorted awkwardly? No, the only food I have in my inventory is literally strange meat. Monk events, let's go. Where are you? You're a necro camp. We have exactly 69 ammo. How healthy are we? We're a little scuffed, but I don't mind running at a necro camp. This is the Nacho Fallen Hero camp. It's not going to be an improved camp. It's in a swamp. No thanks. Over. Perfect. So the next ambition we want to take is the undead ambition, because we need the charm. We need to do a loop south for potions. And we need three real helms, right? We need three real helms, and we need to do a loop south for potions. Overpriced food, let's go. Make money off of this. This is dirt cheap. Buying long range food because we're getting ready to do camps and such. Battle Brothers needs their commander. Let's go. This is coming up. This is doing real well. I'm not gonna complain about sale price, you're just gonna make it work. grappling sticks anymore. I don't actually need the mace anymore, right? Like, I'm not making a mace for home. I don't need it. The hammer I do need. I am fine on axes. Like, I don't need any more great axes, because he's gonna get his axe is right here, and then this guy already has an axe. If he's a hammer, he's a hammer. Okay, cool. So I don't need this axe either. Let's go. Alright. So our tank is short. Our tank is a little short in stats. Or in gear stats anyway. Everybody else looks fine. I don't need this 215 helmet. That's so great. Green skins. How far is it town? I'll find them. Valheim. Valheim is far. I do need to do a contract, right? I guess I could do this contract and walk back, right? The bandit camp too. It's just on a hill. Probably take that. Not too much trouble. Tools or whatever. I need the undead ambition so I can get my my charm. Where is this town? I don't know. don't think I make that much money on this fight. Kind of unbothered about it. Like, let's knock out this contract. And then... I don't know. What's our move after we knock out that contract? What do we need? We need money. So we're probably going on a camp run. Like, very quickly. It's our paper day. I like how we stop raining and we're instantly broke, but... backing everybody up three, because again my throwing lanes are blocked. I needed to fight those nomads because I need better shields. If I'm going to be using my tank, I'm not supposed to use. look might be unironically better. How's your shield doing? Whew, this shield is done. For a bunch of Hulk warriors, this didn't go as bad as it like, kind of doing work here. I need to fix his shield situation too. Like, I need Southern Shield, so I should have bought those new pads. I think that's what some of the like tier 2 orc camps are at too. So this lets me know that I can take the tier 2 orc camps, which is good. Like for the strength check. Just want you out. Yeah. to tell. Like, slightly long gold. We're trying to, like, we just need enough of a cash stack plus tools to, like, go hit camps again, right? Sell price is 17, that's fine. Need to swap out retinue for the scavenger, and then we need to go blow up camps while we're looking for monolith. And if those nomads are still here, I jump on them because I need their shields. What are you? Necro, 13 fallen heroes. Jesus. I mean, that's a high value camp, but just. Please stop. Why are you like this, Battle Brothers? I can buy ammo here. Ammo's cheaper. One mod I've like considered using is serpents. Do they want it? No, probably don't. Serpents profitable to fight? Like, does their stuff sell for a lot? Because we can probably melt them pretty quickly. I don't think so. Like, I don't think serpents are profitable to fight. And we're gonna hit that camp. So we're gonna do this fight and we're gonna hit the camp. Alright, you're good. You're gonna drop your net on the ground. You're good. And drop your net on the ground. You're good. And drop your net on the ground. You're good. Cool. Well, just end the rest of the round. More flask of holy water, but we have time for the beginning to take some trigger, like, just all around in good shape. Thank you. The decaps. Who needs cleavers? Who needs cleavers, boys? Just mowing down zombies. So we'll hit the camp that these things came out of. And then that gives us enough money to go find Monolith while clearing Orc Country. It might be in the back of Goblin Country, but I don't want to fight a bunch of goblins right this second. Like, that's this team's like 1 week fight. I will find my way through Goblin Country if I have to. But I'm hoping Monolith is in the back of Orc Country. Got hit once that fight up here. Perfect. So this is his steel brow. This is like his steel brow recover level, right? I think, let me check my planner real quick. So it's recover, and I have a flex perk I can pick, basically. What am I thinking? Probably Steel Brow. Like, this guy has that's fine. He doesn't quite have enough stam for me to like load up four heavy shields in his inventory, and he's endoming the way I need him to endom. So that's fine. Yeah, that's great. Alright, you guys get your nets back. One day I'll learn the hotkey to like tab bros in your from that screen. Alright, and we hit this camp too. And then the loot from the camps plus the quest should give us enough to go clear. We're throwing this fight because of Fallen Heroes and Necro, so I'm not going to drop the nets. One side looks spicier than the other, we can run the One side looks spicier than the other, we can run the... I keep forgetting not to in round when there's a Necro, because the Necro's gonna run somebody up like that. If I'm going to use my tank as a tank, I would run him up here. I don't think it's a problem. I don't think it's anything I care about. Yeah, res that. Make that one get up, huh? How about that? Sometimes you gotta talk mess to the game. Don't let Battle Brothers punk you. He said for a possessed fallen hero, like, tease off a nimble bro. Ends him. Fearsome is unironically bad into Necros, not because it doesn't do anything to the undead. The undead aren't affected by the death checks, but the Necro is. So the Necro will just run. But Necros have like 200 resolve or something crazy like that. So they just back up, so you have further distance to get to them. Then they rally, and they have infinite cast range on their spells. The Geists still need to move up a step, don't they? Maybe not. he can afford to move here. Got him. Tried it. Probably still too many zombies for me to just go after the guys like that. Himself out of trouble. I'm wrecked with these guys this fight. That's like extra unfortunate. should have switched weapons on this one. It's gotta be some crazy high. Oh, it's not high. I guess that shield is doing a number on us. These guys are on Risen Body duty. These guys are on Kill Necro duty. Man, maybe I should have tanked that. Fallen Hero will stay in a base to base with a Necro. He might step and swing, but okay. That's like perfectly fine though. Possession falls off because the Necro got hit. Just get everybody in here. Necro is now covered. They're not running. This makes me think about that camp that had 13 fallen heroes in it. And I considered it. missing. Let's turn this in. Max tools. Ironically low on meds. Food up here, then let's work on finding Monolith. Like, let's start there. Four days food, I probably need a little bit more. We're also fighting orcs, so kind of whatever. Heal while we walk. We'll start poking at the wilds here, see what we can find. Did monastery, we did edge rock. We need barb weapons. It's tough because so much of my tundra is in Goblin Country. We need the undead ambition so we can get our that's a million wagon webnecks, hex and lots of fun stuff. Scrats, I might fight them because I have the axes for it. Stone pillars, great. We'll be cracking later. There's also a universe where we find goose while we're out here. That would be kind of dope. Check like all of this back here. Or camp. easy orc camp. We fight this. We need to swap our retinue out. Scavenger just doesn't leave us with enough pay. We realistically probably don't need throwing weapons here either. Yeah, probably switching to polearms here. Again, I probably should have just done that turn one and got it before I went to camp. But I had to like see it and feel it out first, I guess. But I mean, I guess I could have always just had him at least had the gnats off. I also don't think I was sure it was going to be a cool mechanic. Still gonna have to keep an eye on food. We do this camp too. It's time to throw weapons out. I would love to find Mama on this trip out, at least. nothing else, we're making money. There'll be like one flat patch of monos. They'll be like right there at the edge of the map. Haven't found Monolith, haven't found Goose, so as long as we keep hitting orc camps, we don't have to worry about food. There's an undead camp around here somewhere. 8 monos. Unholds too spicy. Maybe. They're not aggroing us. So the unholds don't want it, at least. That's a good sign. I'm like not in a hurry to fight that while we're out here trying to conserve tools and ammo. Here, Monolith. I will burn 100% of my ammo trying to clear that camp. We're still going to be out here for a couple days too. Orcs, undead camps. We can do orcs since they just refuse to give me the undead ambition. Let's see. I can fight this if I really want to. I don't want to burn up all the ammo right this second, although I have 225. More importantly, I'm running low on food, so I was expecting four camps. That's not what I'm getting. These are orcs, so there's a camp up here. Try and force a good fatigue or a good hammer bone. Like, if he rolls a 4, as long as he doesn't roll a 2 on fatigue on his next level, I'm not sad. Right? Like, if he rolls a 2, I'm real sad. Okay. I still don't have to commit though, so I can just take Berserk, and then if he misses on Stam, I can do some, like, I can pivot and take it a different direction. Yeah, so Berserk, and then if he misses on Stam, we'll take him a different direction. Like, maybe give him a Bardiche. Like, maybe he gets a Bardiche in reach advantage. I want this fight. 4-6. I'll fight this camp first. Camp is worth more. Um, I'm like standing. I hate it when this happens. I could also run at them to close the distance. Don't auto pass. I wait here because he's going to possess something and it's going to run forward. There was a Necro in the camp, right? Here, what's his defense right now? 75. They're not even trying, they're like trying to go around. Oh wow, I think I hit 5%. Story of my life. This guy can step forward. Did I mess up that guy's long road? I did that. Yeah, 104 shield wall long wolf. 5% only. That said, I am so happy about the long hero guy. This is long wolf still active. It's not. So this guy needs to move back. Take effect next turn. Like, they're just zombies, but he's still, like, out there waiting by himself. And the lower defense might entice a fallen hero to get on him. two guards. That's Nightmare Fuel. That's Nightmare Fuel. Possessed, So if I had counted the tile, if I had counted the tiles, I would have backed up one. We still have 100% drop rate on Great Axes from Fallen Heroes this run. Eventually we need to pick something to push through the necro, but this is still a little spicy for us, I guess. Everybody else can stay on body patrol. How's your shield holding up? 37%? It's fine. This guy can start helping to clean up these. These guys are on res hero patrol. Or res enemy patrol, period.
Oh.
can't believe we have a 100% drop rate on Fallen Hero Great Axe this run. I'm still tripping about that. Like, who needs Chosen when every single Fallen Hero you fight gives you an axe? I gotta admit, these are also so much easier to get. You guys can just stay here on patrol. Go ahead and swap your shoe now. You need to switch up your stand. Like, this guy, I guess, can move up and start cleaning up the zombies on my guy here, right? Like, these three can be on cleanup for this. Good. We'll see what we're doing on food. Like I said, we want to find Monolith while we're out on this trip. Orc country has been pretty sparse, but we are tearing up the orc camps we're finding, which is good. Oh, I said we weren't going to use any more ammo in this fight. Unless we had to. He didn't drop a weapon. I would like step on his corpse and pick up his weapon, but he didn't drop one, so no big deal. I think the main pile up here is done. Stay back, be careful. You don't want like a fallen hero stand up next to a ranged guy randomly while you're trying to wrap up the fight, you know? They're here because the fallen hero is guaranteed to get up at least once if I wait long enough. So they'll just kill that one when he stands up. He's close. Undead fights are easy. You pay for them in IRL time, you know what I mean? Like, the average fight that I play is like 6 turns. Undead fights are like 16 turns. that one's not going to get back up again. You don't need to shield wall because these are going to swing at everything else but you anyway. ...100% drop rate on Great Axes from Fallen Heroes this run. Let's go. Burned a lot of ammo. I'd rather hit another camp. Oh, food. Crap. Ryu. Champion, 7 to 10 Fallen Heroes, and Necro. Do I feel like burning a whole bunch of ammo for a famed shield? I just need enough food to get by. We'll sell here. And then we need to check the rest of this. Orc country is pretty much done, huh? There's an orc camp here for us to hit. That's like goblin country starts up here. We need to check this. Yeah. Clearing pretty well. So let's sell and get back out. Keep running this stuff. We're not making that noble war money anymore, so can't play this one. Set on axes. This doesn't cost any fatigue, right? Alright. Check shop. Don't know why I'm looking at your weapons.
Ooh, I want it.
Oh, it's one-handed. I don't want it. It's awesome. It's very good, but I don't have any bros built for it. Like, you always find awesome weapons when you don't have the bro, you know what I mean? Like, when you don't have the dude who's built for it. There is no 300 helm here. Brother, Hammer Bro is doing this way. I mean, he has reach advantage. I can skip a one and take a resolve roll that he needs. And then basically from here forward, it's like I'm just tweaking other stats. He has reach advantage. He needs hammer spec. Thank you. tank is like awkward because there's so many fights going to be in there. But I'll buy him a drink, maybe I'll this guy's great. Great mid formation. With our ability to go into camps, right? What am I doing? I don't need this ball hammer in here. That wasn't gold efficient at all, but like, it was good. That wasn't gold efficient at all, but now I don't have to, I have less people to feed, so it's gonna be easier for me to keep food while I'm camp clearing. So that's fine. It's like a real thing to think about. That place has ambush trade routes. We're gonna buy food and ammo down here. And what's our pay per day? We'll have 4 days pay. I'll go hit that at night. That should give us enough to go camp clear. Dang it. Raid it again. But yeah, we'll come up here, hit this, and then we'll start clearing orc camps. We might actually hit Monolith by day 225. We need like one more holy water. We have the team. We have all the bros we need. We're almost set on gear. Oh, come on. Come on. What is this? Feel like fighting Alps. Greenskins, where? How far? Oh, this is a... Yes. This is an orc camp. Absolutely. This is like a million fallen heroes, right? Necromancer, 11 to 13 fallen heroes. That just seems so insane. But we're probably fine going into it. I'll do that next. Like our tank can handle that. Cause our tank will get on, will block like four of them. So I'm only, oh. I'll fight that after this game. I wanted a daytime. I have range advantage, right? We'll see how they move first. Axes, Peter. Peter. Okay. So then this is going to be the axe here. Back three on everybody except our tank. Kill the other four pretty easily. Like, this is fine. This is Endom. Lone Wolf is up 75 in depth. He's fine. This way is so instead of stepping into him, if I step into him, it gets in the way of my throwers having two throws next turn. He's reached one of my backliners.
Oh no.
We like action, don't care. Thank you. what's crazy is these are like lowborn that don't have the best stars. Like, there's a, I have one hedge with meh stars. Good base roll. I can't even talk about that. Like, his base roll was like kind of nutty though. Like his base roll was perfect. Watch for bushes. Just in time for me to run out of shields, so he's covered. If I step, he pushes. I don't want that right now. Tank doesn't have a shield anymore. I need to go find nomads and get those shields for that guy. They don't break nearly as easy. Step here, you can't get to my back line. Our tank is also Chad, but he's like, I have to check his background. I think he's like a thief or something. Somebody up, actually. I should probably be taking them more seriously. It's always probably most beneficial for you now. These guys are just never gonna hit benchmark on anything. Somebody holding the spare heater? Yeah. Orc shields are 22 fatigue. Yeah, he can't hold an orc shield. We're out of ammo, so that camp is like off limits, off the table. Nomads. I need to kill those nomads. I need like just enough ammo to do that fight, and all. That's not enough ammo to do that fight. Yes, it is. Okay. Because I need those shields that I don't combine. But I'm guessing this noble company hate them. Yeah. Dang it. This fight tonight, this is on a hill. So we're gonna do our usual, right? We're gonna back up. We're gonna back up, which is going to cause all the archers and stuff to come off this high ground. Like, we get pelted the first round. But literally, we just... Like, they'll walk down into this canyon. this fight specifically makes me wish I had an alternate bro. Or like somebody who was good who I could swap out who wasn't like for this tank. Because like the tank can't doesn't play in these fights, right? Even with Pathfinder, it's like, what does he do? Back up far enough, the archers will come all the way into this crater. And then I don't have to run uphill at them, right? They don't have Pathfinder, right? So when I come, so once they back walk down, they have a very hard time getting back up. So the archers will try and back up if we advance on them, but like it just doesn't matter. Like it actually doesn't matter, right? Because by then it's night, they don't have the height advantage. You're just fighting raiders at night. I know I'm disorganized up here, but I'm just trying to back up as quick as I can, the best I can. And I'm not microwing, so I'm being a little impatient. And like, our Battleforge guys do have Pathfinder. Off their hill, right? They can't back up efficiently, and I have more range units than they do, I think. Kobe. Oh, I tried. Now the raiders are running at us uphill. You know what I mean? Try and reorganize a little bit. Stats and perks, like you just win. update, he already had the correct weapon equipped. Like, these hill fights used to give me so much trouble when I first started playing, man. Like, oh my goodness. Oh man, it was just like, it was nutty, man. Like, and then I learned all you have to do is back up. Like, I remember when I first started, and you're like chain re-rolling the fight, trying to not be in a crater. You know what I mean? He only needs one jab, right? Oh. Dang it. Food doesn't get away. At least as much of it as I can catch. Killed his archer. Alright, good fight. Good fight. Let's go. Like, I've definitely had worse. Like, I've definitely had worse. But yeah, super easy. Good camp loot. Let's reset ourselves. Ammo's a thing. Tools are a thing. So veteran levels are good guys. Always nice. Reasonable sale price. That's fine. I like actually am using regular jabs on people. That feels, it feels so bad. I'm using regular shields because I'm out of heaters. I have Fergusel. That's cool. Alright. Alright. Let's see what ammo looks like up here. We'll buy food and then we'll go back into the wild. Ugh. Food is high too, but I don't care at this point. I just want time. This is undead. Running. That's fine. We'll try and clear that when we walk back. So other than a giant forest, is there anything of value out here? So Monolith is not over here. I kind of want to leave some undead sites because I need to do the undead ambition at some point before Monolith. I need the necklace. Just actually nothing. I mean, there's an undead camp there. Is there a hero in there? Champion? No. It's a 20% fame necro camp. And we need to make money. So we'll pop both of these camps. But I think for now, for this evening, we are good. So we'll hit both of these camps, sell here. Fight nomads, get shields, call it good. But yeah, our team looks way better than like these couple hours we put in. We've had a lot of growth in our gear situation is looking significantly better. Like, that's more than anything else. Like, I'm pretty happy with the progress we made. Like, full battle forged, Izrock armor. We need a helm, and like we could make this work with an attachment. Right, like we need a couple helms. That's it. Like we probably need to stop being so picky about our camps. We probably need to go light on throwing ammo for a while. We definitely need to swap out the retinue. Like once we swap out the retinue, that'll help a lot. But yeah, we're like really close here. Like super close. So made a lot of progress. I'm very happy with it. Like zero complaints. We just have a few things we need to do. I may do some work off stream and like make a little checklist box or something to put in the corner of like the things, like our checklist for what we need to do. Right? But yeah. Like, these guys are close. Like, I could probably, if I found Monolith now, I could probably buy dogs. I could probably buy my dogs. Make sure, like, I have my nets already. Do, like, 1 to 2 loops buying potions, and, like, we're set. So if you had asked me 3 hours ago if this team was going to be ready to do Monolith, I would have said no. But we might actually, like, we're giving ourselves, we basically have 65 days in game to do Monolith again. We have another crisis to scale money. right? Because we can do first crisis was a noble war, or they rotate in order. So next one will be holy war. So then we do holy war for the south. While we're down there, we get our shields, we get our potions. We're set, man. Very, very happy with this team. If you got something out of this stream or you just enjoyed hanging out, hey, feel free to give us a shout, man. Appreciate you. Later.